Welcome back everyone. We were seeing greedy algorithms Knapsack problem. So we have already seen maximum profit approach. Now we are going to see the next approach, which is called as minimum weight approach. So now we will be seeing this minimum weight approach. In the maximum profit approach, we saw that we got a profit of 54 by selecting an item 2 with weight 7 and item 4 with weight 3. Now we'll see the next approach, minimum weight approach. In this minimum weight approach, we are seeing the same set of example. In this, weight of the knapsack is 10 and four items to be inserted in a bag of weight 10. So can we do it? We'll see it here with the minimum weight approach. So what is the approach here is, given a problem with items, four items, and there's weight and profit suitably. So what we have to do is we have to choose them based on the lesser weights first approach. So here I'm going to choose the item with lesser weight. So here amongst all these four items, weight 3 is lesser amongst all of them. So I have chosen weight 3 as the first one. Next is weight 4 as a second. Next is weight 5 as a third one, and weight 7 as the final final in the table of the minimum weight approach. So here, after choosing them based on the lesser weight first approach, we have seen that we got all these in an order. So first one, we are going to choose first weight to be inserted into a bag of 10. So in the knapsack of 10 weight 10, can I insert an item with weight 3? Yes, I can insert. So I am going to select this 3. What is the item, now the bag still capable of holding? It is capable of holding 7 kgs. Can I insert item 4, weight 4, in a bag of 7? Yes, I can insert. So it can, it is now capable of holding 4. So total weight is 3 plus 4 7, in a bag of 10. So it has now occupied, the bag has now occupied 7 kgs, and it is still capable of holding 3 more kgs. Can I insert a weight of 5 kg in a bag of 3 kg? No, I cannot insert. Can I insert a 7 kg in a bag of 3 kg? No, I cannot insert. So what is the total profit earned right now from this? From inserting a weight 3, I have earned profit 12. By inserting weight 4, I have earned profit 40. So total profit which I am earning here by inserting these two items is 52. So this is the profit earned after inserting the two items. So this is the end of your end of the minimum weight approach. So here I have inserted the items with the minimum weight. The drawback with this is, even though I am capable of inserting 3 more kgs of an item, but I still cannot do it because this is 01 knapsack. So we'll see the next approach, which is called as profit by weight ratio approach. Again, the same set of data I'm having. In this data, one extra data I have included is the profit divided by weight ratio. So here, these give us the ratios. This is the per kg profit. Suppose, for example, if I divide 40 divided by 4, I'm going to earn 10 profit. What is this 10? This is a profit earned from 1 kg of an item. Suppose from 4 kg, if I am going to take only 1 kg, what is the profit earned? It is 10. From 7 kg, if I remove only 1 kg, what is the profit earned? It is 6. So like this, it is the per kg data given us from the given data. Okay. So now what we are doing is profit divided by weight ratio. We'll see how to use it. So first one is, can I select item 1? Can I select item 1, this one, with weight 40 to be inserted in a bag as a whole? Yes, I can. So I am going to insert item 4, weight 4, and what is the profit earned? Total profit earned is 40. Can I insert item 2 in a bag which is having now capable of holding only 6 kgs? No, I cannot insert. But This is a part of fractional knapsack. So I cannot insert 7 kg. Can I insert 6 kgs? Can I take only 6 portion of the 7 portions? Yes, I can take. So with respect to this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select 6/7 portion of an weight. That means I am going to use 6 into 6. 6 is what? 6 is the 6 is the 6/7 portion. That means 6 kgs among 7 kgs I am selecting, and 6 is the profit earned. So 6 is the profit earned. So total, what is the profit? Total is 36. So after this, what is the remaining amount to be inserted? So I have inserted 4 in a bag of 10, remaining is 6. I have inserted 6 in a bag of 6, so total weight remaining is 0. So now my bag is full. So what is the total profit earned right now after doing this? So total profit earned is 40 plus 36 76, is the total profit earned. So profit earned is 76. So with respect to this, now we got a profit on 76 as per profit by weight ratio. So in accordance with the profit by weight ratio, we earned profit 76. In accordance to minimum weight approach, we earned the profit 52, and in accordance with maximum profit approach, we earned the weight 54. So I'll represent them according to their scales and the weights. So based on this maximum weight approach, we earned profit 54. Okay, is this correct? 54 is a profit earned. And minimum weight approach, it was 52. And profit by weight ratio, we earned as 76. So comparing all these three approaches, we are going to get the better solution by solving profit by weight ratio, and which it is much giving us the much higher result compared to these two these three approaches. So profit by weight ratio approach is the best among the greedy algorithms to solve knapsack problem. So thank you.